As my colleague was trying to say, good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the second annual Mishawaka High School Performing Arts Showcase. Tonight, we are going to showcase,
get it?
Some of our talent in dance, theater, and song. Now, before we get started, Spencer, are we following all the current CDC guidelines?
Well, Aaron, the CDC now states that I don't have to answer that question. They also state that you can now run with scissors. Scary, isn't it? Oh, and just as the quarantine time shortens to 5 days, so do the Ten Commandments. 5 is enough, so just choose which one to throw up.
Awesome. I'll throw up killing, stealing, adultery, honoring your parents. Sorry, Mom. And I guess false idols. It seems that all the good idols have been taken from us.
You're going to be a menace to society. You can run with scissors and murder? Well, I guess, even if someone dies, the show must go on.
Speaking of death, always a fun topic. So many great people have been taken from us lately. Betty White.
I know.
Bob Saget.
So sad.
Sidney Poitier.
The one and only. Wait, who was that?
He was one of the most important actors in cinema history. But he's old, so we don't really care about him.
Cinema. Got it.
Well, just the other day, I lost my pet fish, Gerald.
Sushi.
I don't think a goldfish is very appetizing.
Hey, Eric, do you think Bruno killed your fish?
Shh. We don't talk about Bruno. No. We don't talk about Bruno.
But we just write entire songs about him and explain everything.
Who was in that movie again?
Tom Holland? You can't escape Tom Holland.
No, he was in Spider-Man Far From Home.
I don't think I've seen it yet. I've only seen the one with Tobey Maguire as Spider-Man. Or was it Andrew Garfield? Hey, wouldn't it be so cool if they were in the same movie together?
Yeah, for sure. While we're speaking of rotating male leads, who's the new head coach of Notre Dame football?
Who? Oh, you mean Marcus Freeman.
Yeah, he seems to fit right in. Better than Brian Kelly with that big Southern accent. But we will talk about why we're here tonight. To showcase all of our amazing talent and our performers, and to thank the people who made it happen. And we would love to give a big thank you to Mishawaka High School Principal, Mr. John Ross, Fine Arts Coordinator, Mr. Matthew Brown, and our Fearless Director, Ms. Rachel Such, for pulling us here tonight. We have gone through many obstacles, especially those 3 midwinter breaks. I love those days off.
So once again, welcome to the second annual Mishawaka High School Performing Arts Showcase, and enjoy the show! Maestro.
A, D, 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 F sharp, A will be the first notes of our show.
We'll start with the seed of an idea, then plant it onto a paper with a Dixon tie. Musical, and then we'll have
That really was something, wasn't it?
Yes! What was that song from again?
That song was from Title of Show, and the name of the song was Untitled Opening Number.
Oh yeah, the show about two guys making a musical, about two guys making a musical.
Yeah, not confusing at all, right? While we have you all here tonight, we'd like to give a big thank you to our tech and our crew. In the sound booth tonight, we have Hunter Flick and Hope Harris. Let's give them a big round of applause for all of their hard work and dedication. Our spotlight operators are Maxwell Collins and Isabella Butler. Let's give them a very big thank you for their efforts.
So without further ado, we'd like to introduce you to our first act of the night. This act will actually be performing three times throughout the show, so be prepared to see them multiple times. Our first scene will be Falling Away From You, directed by Mr. Aaron Heklinski and performed by Dylan Piazzoni and Eliana Stepp.
Every time I fly, I wonder why I'm flying. Especially when I'm flying alone. What's the point of my leaving behind? What if you're not there when I get back?
Do you really worry about that?
I worry about everything.
Why now? I thought you were better.
I am. I was, most of the time.
Are you okay?
Not really.
Is it that hard for you?
Everything is hard for me. Well, it was. I thought I'd be okay on my own, but you're my anchor. You keep me steady.
I want to, but is it that hard without me?
I feel like I'm in a fog, slightly out of sync. I'm here on this crowded street, but I don't see anyone. They don't see me either.
I see you.
You always do.
I see you so much more than you see yourself.
I want to be that person you see. I really do.
Then be that person.
I'm scared.
Of what?
I don't know. Everything. The world scares me.
Little trouble. start pink champagne. But not any pinker than a rose is. Her skin may be delicate and soft, but not any softer than a doll's is. Her neck is no wider than a swan's. She's only as dainty as a daisy. She's only as graceful as a bird. So why is the fellow going crazy? Oh, why would a fellow want a girl like her? A girl who's merely lovely. Why can't a fellow ever once prefer a girl who's merely me? What's the matter with a man? What's the matter with a man? What's the matter with a man? Yes, he's witty.
Trey newcomer, Abigail Singleton, and Abigail Taylor. So everyone, let's give a warm welcome to the No Fear, No More dance group.
Thank you.
Sometimes I wish I could dance like that, but for now I'm just stuck knowing how to ballroom dance.
Don't feel bad you can't do those sick moves that everybody loves watching, that hype room. Just be satisfied with knowing how to dance in a circle that makes people feel kind of bored. No, seriously, those moves will come in handy at a wedding or a senior citizen's dance.
For now, can we just get through with the next phase of our lives? The ever dreaded and most hated new step for in life for any 18-year-old. Instead of worrying about what we're going to do when we're 18.
And what exactly is the ever dreaded, most hated new step in life for an 18-year-old, Gary?
Well, that would be college.
Oh, yeah. nothing.
While on the topic of college, let's introduce our next act.
Yes, interviews are so stressful, and nobody knows that better than our next two performers. Starring Carrie Young and Trey Newcomer, here is 13 Ways to Screw Up Your College Interview.
Thank you.
You know, with the whole college energy being up here on stage, I was thinking about something, Spencer.
And that is?
This is our last few months in high school. We only have 96 days left as a senior in high school. That's one more spring choir concert, one more school dance, and one more Mayfest concert. So sad.
I think you're forgetting about one last thing, Aaron. This year's spring musical.
How could I forget about that? Yes, this spring, on the dates of April 29th, 30th, and May 1st, Mishawaka High School presents Susical the Musical.
Susical has never been done at Mishawaka High School, and is truly a super fun, exciting, and challenging show.
This show truly does bring out every aspect of the fine arts. We have acting, dancing, and singing. Lots and lots of singing.
We also have Mr. Ryan Sargent leading the way for the concept art. What is that? He will come up with a design based on the director's vision. And where does that go?
Very good question, Spencer. After that, he will then send it to our construction team, led by Ms. Kylie Murphy.
Yes, this show truly does collaborate so much within our local community here at MHS.
And it's also fun for the kids and the adults. This show tells stories that we all grew up with. With many songs that will rhyme, a night of Susical will be a wonderful time. I can't wait to see you all there, and after the show, there'll be stories to share.
Aaron, you're speaking in rhymes yourself.
Am I really? I don't think I was. You mustn't have heard me clearly.
Well, if he's gonna keep rhyming, I may as well introduce our next act. Our next act is a song from a musical that's somewhat popular. I mean, some of you may have heard of it. It's called Hamilton. Directed by Miss Rachel Such and performed by Venus Hartley, Chloe Kinnear, Cadence Radovoff, Eliana Stout, and Kara Young, we now present First Birth.
That's why.
Away from you.
Yes, dear. I see distinctly on the pair of the horse.
Ruth.
I will let
cannot stay here on me any longer.
Hooray!
Shut up.
Don't speak to me like that.
Ruth, listen, please, listen.
Do not listen to any more of this nonsense. I am going to go. I'm just too hard. I shan't be asleep. I'm too upset. You could come take it back to me if you feel like it.
That's big of her, I must say.
Be quiet. You're behaving like a gutter snake.
All I have to say, good night, Charles.
Well, that was one of the most enjoyable half hours I ever spent.
Oh, Vera, how could you?
Poor Ruth.
This has to be some sort of hallucination, isn't it?
Well, I'm afraid I don't know the technical term for it.
What am I to do?
What Ruth suggested, relax.
Are you here to stay indefinitely?
Well, I don't know that either.
Oh, God.
Why? Would it be so bad if I did?
Well, you must admit me, so embarrassing.
I don't see why, really. It's all a question of adjusting yourself. Anyhow, I think it's horrid of you to be so unwelcoming and disagreeable.
Now look here, Vera.
I do think you're mean!
You can't see my point here.
No.
I've been married to Ruth for 5 years and you've been dead.
Not dead, Charles! Passed over! It's considered morbid to see dead where I come from.
Passed over then?
At any rate, the least you could do is make a pretense of being amiable about it.
Well, I'm delighted in one way.
I don't believe you love me anymore.
I shall always love the memory of you.
Well, you mustn't think me unreasonable, Charles, but I really am a little hurt. You conjured me up, and at a great inconvenience, I came, and you've been thoroughly churlish ever since I cried.
Believe me, I most emphatically did not send me. There's been some sort of mistake.
Good at slow dancing. But you know, I guess I wasn't good enough to get cast in this act. And instead, I get to stand up on stage talking to all you lovely people. You're still here, right? I can't see past the blinding spotlights.
Well, since you are all still here, why not stay for another act? Our next act is Slow Dancing in the Dark, choreographed by Venus Hartley and performed by Venus Hartley, Lorelei Hensel, Danielle Horvath, and Mariah Howard and Cadence Radabug. We hope you enjoy it. Agony from Instagram. the first of two songs that you will hear from Into the Woods. We chose to feature this show due to the composer's recent passing. So, in memory of Stephen Sondheim, I now present to you our next act, directed by Mr. Matthew Brown and performed by Dylan Piazzoni. And hey, I guess that's where he went. You know him, you love him, Aaron Eklinski.
She was there, the cupboard was bare, and the dog had nothing.
We don't have a dog.
We don't have a bone.
We don't need a bone.
We need cereal.
Are you going to help me get these plants in?
Milk, coffee. Alicia, the deal was I paid the rent and you paid for the food. And there's no food. No drink. No caffeine. I need my caffeine.
Are you going to help?
You're serious. You're going to spend your entire paycheck on plants for New Jersey.
I'm taking a stand. Wishy-washy Nisha's finally committed to something. I'm going to make New Jersey Garden State in reality. Down with Fuse's license plate slogans, up with truth and beauty.
New Jersey, the food is set. I need food. I'm crumbling.
Oh, Shade, that's brilliant. We'll make New Jersey the vegetable garden state. We'll plant our food at city lots, we'll be gatherers, and we'll feed the state.
Can bacon be part of the equation? Can you grow bacon?
Kale! Healthy and ornamental kale! The garden shop's a few blocks away. Do you have any money? Kale's only about $3.99 per plant.
Not kale, please, Alicia. Anything but kale.
Relationships really are so much fun.
Yes, especially really good friendships.
You know a musical that shows a good development of a great friendship?
Wicked!
My thoughts exactly! Our next act is from Act 2 of Wicked, directed by Miss Rachel Such and performed by Eliana Stout and Tia Stopczynski. We present For Good from Wicked.
Something we
will say that developing good friendships like that is very essential in life.
Yes, I mean, I know that I've made some very long-lasting friendships within Mishawaka's theater program.
Theater really is a place where many people come together in unity to provide entertainment and joy for the people of the community.
Yes, theater is a place where people from all different backgrounds, ethnicities and religions and any other sorts of beliefs can come together and share in an action that they all love to do.
I truly can't wait to see where the journey of life takes me from here.
You know, I'm still super interested in the relationship between Mel and Nell. I really want to know how it all ends.
Well, lucky for you, the finale of the act is here. We've seen sadness, and we've seen love. I think I can say we've all hoped for a happy ending between those two. Now, it's time to see. Will love prevail over the stresses and commotion of the world?
What's going on? Is someone hurt?
I don't hear them.
They're getting closer.
You'll be okay.
I want to be with you. I'm so scared. Just wish I knew where they were going.
Nowhere. They're going nowhere.
That's how I feel. Nowhere. Going nowhere. Without you, it's nowhere.
I felt that way before.
Love being part of
them. Like two halves.
I became one. You were made for me. I really believe you were made for me.
I am yours.
Give them a bottle. Now that's what flying for. To reach up high enough to catch you. A spirit in the clouds. My angel.
You're so sweet to me.
I hope so. You mean so much to me.
I better go now. Are you going to be okay?
I think so. It helps to see you, to hear you.
Is it enough?
I never get enough. World's too demanding.
Don't let anything get in the way of us.
The world's screaming at me. I don't want to listen anymore.
Then don't listen. Shut it out. Listen to my voice. Listen to my words. I love you.
Such sweet words. I love you.
When you say them, yes.
I miss you so bad. I always think I want to go somewhere, but I'm always sorry when I do. I thought I had to take a journey to find happiness, but in reality, happiness is right at home with you. I guess the journey's made me appreciate you more. I journeyed so far, but the best thing was right at my door. I mean, who would have thought the best thing in the universe was only to walk away, but flying? No great voyage, just turn around, look, and that's something good, right? Just trying to find some good because I don't feel so good right now. Alone. I hate being alone. The plane eats me up and I feel like I'm falling away from you.
Such a somber note. Maybe we should lighten it up a little. This showcase has been wonderful, and that is, of course, in part, due to the contributions not only of our production team, directors, and actors, but to all of you, our lively audience.
Yes, we can see you past the bright spotlights, the friends and family, and all of the parents who have supported us.
A parent's job is never easy,
I mean, your kids may hear you, they may listen, but they don't always obey.
And that's what our finale is all about!
Yes, sometimes people leave you before you're ready to say goodbye. And yes, the show is over. And we'll see you in the spring. So until then, you have to hear us sing. Finale, from Into the Woods by Stephen Sondheim, a Broadway composer and an icon. We chose this piece and the Agony Act to pay tribute to his legacy. This is the finale of a show that is all about coming together and overcoming challenges. We felt like this was a message to be shared. Before we leave you, we have one final shout out. Thank you to Mr. Dieter, our accompanist, for accompanying all of these acts. He has worked tirelessly to help us prepare, and on behalf of all the actors and performers, we thank you. Once again, thank you all for coming tonight and supporting all of our amazing talent. We hope you enjoy the show.